Good morning, YouTube. It is 11:45 this Sunday. Happy Sunday. I am just autopiloting to do all the prep for my run. I got up, put on sunscreen, got dressed, had my pre-workout, and also had some coffee. And I'm just not in like the mood exactly. I'm just not super psyched for the run right now, but I've done all the stuff to do it. And I've already taken the pre-workout, so I can't not go. I discovered that I prefer jogging one particular path, which is one of the roads nearby where they closed it to traffic, and it's already a residential street that's relatively quiet because it's a lot easier to social distance from other people. So you're actually allowed to jog on the road itself. And the road is really wide. You can probably fit like 3 cars side by side. So even when there is the occasional car, it's easy for you to spot, it's easier for them to go around you. It's very, very slow amount of traffic. But that road is also hilly. The advantage of being able to keep 6 or 10 feet away from everyone is that it's still okay to have your mask off. Whereas when I go down Market, which I did last Sunday because I wanted to go down to the Castro, just went down Market and back, you keep on running into people all the time. So whenever I would see someone approaching, I would pull my mask back up, and then once they were past, I would pull it back down. The result was that my bandana got super, super slobbery, and then halfway through, it smelled disgusting, but it just smelled like saliva. And I had to keep on putting it back on because there was just too many people on Market. So I'm thinking I'm gonna jog the exact same way I did yesterday, which was the hilly but deserted, blocked off stretch of road where cyclists and runners can just be on the pavement itself. Even though it's a little more hilly, I'm just do a slightly slower jog today. We'll see how I feel. But it is a lot nicer to not have to wear the bandana when you're doing an actual jog. We are back. That was a harder run in a good sense. There were a few hills. I went back to Painted Ladies, the park over there. Took a slightly different route to switch things up a little bit, and I jogged up the hills. And then even for parts where like I would have sometimes just taken a break and walked, I just kept on jogging. So it's a faster run today. I pushed myself a little bit more, so that's really good. The best part is the run is over, and this is the longest until the next run next weekend, and this is the final day of the weekend, so I'm gonna do nothing for like an hour or two. Freezing the entire day. It's gone quite a bit colder. It was very, very windy today as well. There was one point I was coming back from the run. I was waiting at an intersection about to cross, and it was like so super gusty, like sideways. I've been cold the entire time since I've gone back home. It's kind of nice. I prefer it to be a little bit cooler than for it to be too warm. I'm not looking at the news today because I'm pretty sure in terms of government news locally in San Francisco or in LA, in terms of restrictions and stuff, usually it's not very active. The governor in California just had an announcement on Friday. The national news right now, so crazy that I just want to give myself and my anxiety a break for like a day. Instead, let's read some of your comments. Ron says, you can Google LA crime rate map and click images, and then you can check some of the crime maps online. I have done that before, actually. It was the last time and the only time I moved to LA. Taz DeVille says, jocks and thongs are the most uncomfortable pieces of clothing any dude can wear. Who came up with the design? I go for bikini designs. Feels like I'm not wearing anything. Boxer designs don't fare that well either. I think underwear is a relatively personal choice. You know, I have a collection of different types of underwear, and then there are definitely different styles that I gravitate to depending on the occasion. But surprisingly, the materials mix
a pretty big difference. I just like the underwear that have thick waistbands because the waistband itself usually I feel is uncomfortable. Little Asian Kid Forever says, have you ever had a BF or a husband? I've not been married. I've not really had a boyfriend. That's a whole other story. Seems like you've been single for as long as you've been on YouTube. That is correct. Are your parents pushing you to get married? No one is pushing me to get married. I actually did a video on coming out. This was 2017 or 2018. I try to link it at the end of this video as one of those clickable tiles at the end of the YouTube video. Lum says cork flooring absorbs sound. You have mentioned you don't like noise from other units. It's mainly footsteps from above, and me putting in cork flooring won't help the noise from the neighbors above me. Christopher says, vinyl floors are great. We installed them in all our guest rooms at my hotel a couple years ago. Installation is very easy. I looked a little bit into it. It looks like it's a new kind of category of flooring. These vinyl planks, a lot of them are made to emulate wood, and some of them are better than others. I did do some looking today just at houses and stuff, and I don't know if I want to do a remodel unless I find like a really good place in a really good building, in a really good location for like a really good price. We'll see. I'm still waiting for more listings to come onto the market. Nothing has quite caught my eye yet. Taz DeVille again says, please get the history of the house before you buy. What happened to the former owners? You don't want anything gruesome now if you catch my drift. Don't worry, I'm working with professionals. I have friends who purchased multiple pieces of real estate before, and I have not only my proper LA realtor, I also have a friend who's also a realtor here in San Francisco, and they're giving me lots of good advice. K-Osk says, I have been house hunting in San Francisco for a while. There has not been too many new listings in the area I'm looking within my price range either. Oh my god, San Francisco is so expensive. I definitely cannot afford any places in San Francisco for sure. Last comment from M. Johnson says, glad you get all of those HGTV shows on Hulu. On house hunting, inventories were already pretty low before coronavirus. Nowadays, even less people are not willing to sell and move. Shortage creates bidding wars, multiple buyers. Sections of LA is probably not an exception to that. I have vinyl floors in my place that look like hardwood floors. Came with the house, but it's nice. But I could tell that it was vinyl the first time that I saw it. If you're stuck with carpeting, think about having a Woburn carpeting. I would not be stuck with carpeting. There are way too many listings that have hardwood floors or hardwood-like floors that I don't have to settle. The majority of them actually have either hardwood or hardwood-esque flooring, whether that be like an engineered hardwood or a really nice laminate. There was one listing that I passed completely because the HOA just said carpet for everyone. I was like, nope, sorry, bye. On the topic of the house hunt, it almost seems like my views on it are evolving every day. I think that's kind of typical because I'm a first-time home buyer and I'm only about a month into kind of looking at listings and the whole process. I've done a few virtual tours with my agent, and it's very tempting for sure to sometimes see listings pop up or auto-suggested by the website of things that are a little outside your price range, but it tempts you to kind of click on it. I think I made the decision that I just am gonna really stick to the lower end of my budget. I could go more expensive. The nicer house, that dream house, can come in like 5 or 10 or 15 years if I have the money to spend on a bigger, nicer house then. This is not my forever house. I don't need it to be super awesome, super nice. I just need it to be a good investment, a place that I wouldn't mind staying for like 10 years, but if prices appreciate a stupidly high amount in 5 years and I was like, wow, this is a really great time to sell right now, then it'll be a type of property that I can really easily sell. Sooner than I think, I'm gonna be traveling again anyways, and traveling, I know very well how much money that costs me. So I'm gonna put my foot down on the budget and the type of listings I look at, but I feel pretty good about it. I've thought it through. Okay, we're gonna go very different. Well, not very different, but we're gonna go for an embarrassing one today for the song of the day. I can take your hand and fly you anywhere you wanna go, yeah. I can be everything you need. If you're the one for me, like gravity, I'll be unstoppable. This is the song from a Disney movie. And obviously, knowing my taste by now, you guys, this is from like a Disney movie meant for teens. The movie is called Starstruck. In the movie, there's a character called Christopher Wilde, and he is a pop star. The song is called Hero, and this is one of his songs.
I just realized that we're frighteningly close to 100 daily vlogs. I remember back when it was like, I don't know, the 20th or 30th vlog that I said, we'll see if we get to 50. And then somehow the idea of doing 100 of these or being in sheltering in place for 100 days was like, doing this after 100 days, I'm gonna like go crazy. I'm gone crazy yet, but 100 days in this environment is a lot. I think originally either I anticipated that offices would be reopened a little bit earlier, back when it was like, I don't know, the middle of March when I started doing this. And then a little bit later when I decided to move to LA, that maybe I'm finding a place in LA a little bit quicker. But that was before I got myself acquainted with the finer details of buying a house. There are certain timelines for that. I don't know. I feel like we probably will make it to 100 vlogs. Are we gonna continue after 100? No, it's not possible to find a condo or a house I wanna buy and move into it before we hit 100. I just did some quick math. I wouldn't save any money if I move myself down to LA. I mean, if I crash with some friends, I would save a lot of money, but I really don't like putting people out of the way unless it's absolutely necessary. I feel like if I'm gonna move down there early before I find a permanent place to live, I should just pony up the money for like temporary accommodations. We'll see what happens. It's getting a little bit harder to be really optimistic about the house hunt right now. There's actually a listing that came up today and it's like, well, I could theoretically purchase that. I'm a relatively picky person, it's true, and I know this. It's just when I'm throwing around this much money, I'm gonna be like the boss of that situation. I'm consulting with friends, I'm consulting with realtors, so I'm getting expert advice. But you know, at the end of the day, I have to feel comfortable with one of the biggest purchases in my life. We're only about a month in. There's more inventory coming onto the market. I'm not in a huge rush to get down there, so I can afford to wait. And if we get to the point where I can't afford to wait for whatever reason, I have options available. But I would really love it if maybe before the end of this month, something materializes that I'll see that listing, I'll tour it, and then I say, I'm gonna put in an offer. Like, I really want this place. All right, folks, that's gonna do it for today's vlog. It's been a fairly quiet weekend. I was supposed to clean my shower this weekend, but I'm gonna do that during the week. I did laundry for my clothes, but I'm almost out of towels. So we'll do the towels and the laundry sometime this week. And then we'll also do the linen as well, the bed linen. But I think I'm just gonna take it easy for the rest of the night. We are going back into work tomorrow. I don't wanna go back to work until tomorrow. Bye, YouTube.